Let's talk about how to interpret your standardized test scores. Let's say you've taken the SAT or the ACT. The scales that they've come up with aren't the thing you're used to in school. You know, it's not a 75 is a C and a 93 is an A or something like that. So sometimes students have difficulty understanding what they are. So the average score, so first of all, SAT scores go from 200 to 800. And you have three sections on your SAT, so your total score is usually 600 to 2400, 2400 being a perfect score. The ACT goes 1 through 36 for each section. There's four sections on the ACT. And then of the four sections, they just add those four up and then divide by four, and that's your composite score. So your composite score is also going to be between 1 and 36, 36 being a perfect score. So obviously a 2400 on the SAT and a 36 on the ACT correspond. Those are both perfect scores. The national average for the ACT is about 21. It's actually about 21 on all four sections, and it's 21 for the national average. To give you a sense of the comparison, the national average in general for the SAT is about 500. So 500 out of 800 is the national average, which makes sense. It's actually in the middle of these two, and they did that on purpose. So a 21 on the ACT is about equivalent to a 500 on the SAT. The last thing that's important to know is that when you're looking at interpreting your standardized test score, when you look at your raw score on either test, you know, normally in school, let's say you're an A student and you try to get a 90 every time you take a test. So you want 90% correct. Whereas, you know, let's say a 50 out of 100, 50% would be an F. You'd be disappointed. On the SAT, those don't really relate. Like half right on the SAT, which would be an F in school, is actually about a 500. It's actually the average score across the country. So more like a C, if you want to think of it that way. So it's kind of interesting. You can't just look at your percentage correct and call that your score. You have to look at your scaled score and call that your score because it's such a high scale on the test, really.